how would you cut weight?
So when I was cutting weight before, when I used to fight, it would basically be over a long span of time. There was only one instance where I cut a weight. I lost about 14 pounds in less than 24 hours.
Okay, we want to know how you did that.
Well, I was supposed to fight at 170, and my guy got injured, and then another guy at 155 on the same card had ended up getting hurt.
Okay.
So I wanted to still fight on that show because it was in my hometown. It was a good opportunity for me to go out there and have my friends and support. Or it's very rare that you don't get an opportunity to fight in front of your hometown.
Yeah.
So I had a choice. I had to make the weight. So basically all I did, I stuck myself in the sauna. I put a sauna suit on. I skipped in the sauna. I did Epsom salt baths. It was pretty much the whole time. I went right from there to the weigh-in.
Okay, so did you do that for a day? Like you're in a sauna for a day?
We need almost specifics. 10 hours.
You're in a sauna for 10 hours? Okay, are you drinking or eating anything?
Little sips of water.
Okay, you make the weight.
Yeah.
You go to weigh in.
Yeah.
You made the weight exactly like same as your opponent, let's just say. Do you have to be right on the mark?
It's plus or minus. Depends on the organization and who's commissioning it. So.
Okay, so plus or minus a couple of kilos?
Pounds.
Pounds, okay. Yeah. So, $1 million question I'm dying to know is, how fast does that weight come back on?
Oh, like instantaneously. Usually what we do is we get Pedialytes. So we'll buy like kids' Pedialyte jars of that, which has a lot of electrolytes.
Okay.
And you just start rehydrating your body.
So how fast is it coming on? Like the next day?
Oh yeah, I had 20 pounds back the next day. By the time you're in the fight. So that's why when you see the pros that are out there, when you see them at the weigh-ins, they're all shredded and they looked really good. And then by the time they go to the fight, they put that weight all back
Incredible.
On.
Incredible. Now, is it water weight or liquid weight?
Yeah,
is that
water.
What it is?
Yeah.
Okay, water and liquid. So we talked about that UFC fighter, that female that fainted 3 times trying to do her weigh-in. And then I saw her post-press conference and she was basically just saying, hey, I made weight at like 5 a.m., but my mistake was waking up way too early.
Mm-hmm.
And you told me an interesting story about you when you used to cut weight. So like, what is the trick here? Like, should you wake up and go weigh in? Is that the only reason, or is this really unhealthy?
I mean, everybody's different that way.
Okay.
But I think that I never did that right away, because what would happen is when you wake up, sometimes you might be a little bit heavier. It depends. Obviously, you don't eat or nothing. You're still drinking, just very minimal. But if you need to cut that weight, you need to have that time to do it. So if I wake up in the morning and I'm still 2 pounds overweight, I need to put the sauna suit on, I need to start skipping, and I need to sweat that out.
Sounds pretty healthy, Jesse. Like, that doesn't sound too bad, because I know I had even messages after the last interview and they were saying, well, I'm going to do that for bikini season. I am not recommending anything on this show, anything of that nature. That's crazy, right? Because the second you told me the next day, you're gaining 20 pounds.
Yeah.
So it makes no sense to do that. This is just for professional fighting.
Yeah. Yeah, and it's something that with my guys, I always make sure that they do a pre-cut or maybe even 2 pre-cuts prior to them actually having to cut for the event.
That's good.
Because everybody, like I say, they react differently, and that's a prime example of her passing out, right?
Yeah.
Where she had depleted herself so much and didn't prepare herself properly, that maybe if she hadn't done that before, she would have known the results would have been already like... She put herself at really bad risk there. Right?
So the fights that we see televised, you know, UFC and so forth, are they eating the day that they're fighting?
Oh, 100%.
Okay, they're eating in the morning and then 100%. Fighting at night?
Yeah.
Carbs?
Yeah, loading up whatever they can take. They're going to have carbs in the morning, like a big breakfast. I mean, everybody's different the way they do it. I have one of my old pros, and he had cut weight almost 20 pounds within a week.
Okay.
And it was really hard for me to get him to cut. He made the weight, which was fine, but then what problem was is his body rejected any food while he was trying to rehydrate. So before his fight he only had 2 McNuggets.
2 McNuggets.
That's all he could eat, and he still got sick and spit that up.
Yeah,
so you can imagine how his body feels when he's going into an adrenalized state fighting and he's got no food for energy, nothing. Yeah.
So what's the gap that we leave between food and fighting? How many hours?
I mean, I would probably say you're eating up, you know, you got to digest your food, right?
Yeah.
So at least a couple hours before, and you're eating really light stuff as you're going up to it.
Okay.
Usually have a big breakfast in the morning, something, you know, reload, get the carbs, start replenishing your body.
Okay.
And then just like snacking throughout the day.
Can you give me a good snack? We're snackers here in Star Wars. I need a good snack.
I mean, you know, like salads, Caesar salads,
okay.
Almonds, fruits. Okay. Anything that's healthy, that's not going to make you feel sluggish.
Okay.
You know, because you want to feel amazing when it's time to go, fighting.
Right? Yeah. I've never seen anybody vomit in a cage.
Oh, okay.
Has that happened? You're smiling.
Yeah, it has happened.
For sure. I can imagine training and like throwing up, but fighters have actually gotten sick in the ring 100%. From eating too close to fight time.
Yeah, probably not digested their food for sure. It could be nerves as well.
Nerves.
Like it could be a reaction from your body just with the adrenalized state and everything. I mean, you're going in there. Once that door closes, that's it. It's you and this other guy. And if your head's not in it or you're not feeling well, then you know a lot of things can happen.